This is how I get my exercise when I need it. Now, time for some more buffness. I've kind of cut some scores in this to help up with breaking it off. I don't want to go all the way down. This gives me something nice to lay my rebar mesh on to keep it from going down to the ground. Back in the days before Mexicans, this is the way white folks worked too. Enough of me, y'all watching me working. You don't need to see any more of that. But I'll keep at it till I get knocked out. Well, I guess that's success. I've managed to beat everything down to the height I need to run the wire through here. That's all I had to do on this, dig it out, pack the dirt in. Get a nice foundation, good hard clay back. So I trampled it all down, beat it in with a sledgehammer, got it back down good. So the next thing to do is to get the plastic in here and then start pulling in wire. So it ought to go pretty quick now. This was the dreaded part, was breaking up all this concrete, getting it moved and dug out. So got one more section to do the next time. That'll be it for the concrete. As far as the destruction that has to be done anyway, the hard part. So I've got all the sawdust vacuumed up and the wood pieces all picked up out of this section. I don't want anything underneath the floor that's going to rock and cause voids. So I want everything to be nice and tight packed. And that way the concrete will hold up better. I don't plan on dropping any more 30,000 pound pieces on top of it, so that should help it to hold up better. But since it held up as good as it did, I guess with that impact, I know that I'm doing a decent job of putting this concrete in here. Otherwise, it probably would have gone through the floor on a standard floor instead of just sitting on top of it. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this. Getting to watch me work. I know you all like to see me do the hard manual labor sometimes, so you got to see it on this time. Thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing. I'll catch y'all later. In case you're wondering, Bailey's out chasing coyotes. It's too dark for me to shoot him. It's like 10 o'clock, so I can't see him, can't help him out, and he's not here to do the inspection and sign off, but as soon as I go to the house, he'll show up.